Hello all. Today we are going to start with chapter 1 of economics. Till grade 8 you were studying about only three sections of SST or social studies or social science, that history, civics and geography. Today from 9th onwards one more wing is added to it, and that is economics. First of all, it's important to understand that what is economics. Economics in simple language is a way of satisfying people with goods and services, consumption level of their interest, as well as it is about supply of money. How to satisfy these goods and services? To understand this thing a little bit in a broader concept, we are going to start with the first chapter of economics, that is the story of village Palampur. Okay, this chapter, the story of village Palampur, this chapter is already given in your book, so I'll be reading it slow by slow with you all and be explaining you. Okay, the purpose of the story. Now, overview of this chapter. This chapter is like the purpose of the story is to introduce some basic concepts relating to production, and this we do through a story of an hypothetical, that is an important word to understand, hypothetical village. So it is an imaginary village. It is not actually, you can find it, but yeah, this is an imaginary village which can be related to any of the village you might have visited or you might have heard about. Yeah, so the word hypothetical is used here. Yeah, so we are going to do that. Farming is the main occupation, or you can say main activity in Palampur, whereas several others activities such as small scale manufacturing, dairy and transport, etc. are carried out on a limited scale. These production activities needs various type of resources. Definitely any sort of production needs various type of resources. A few of them are listed here. First is natural resources. The example can be land for agriculture, water resources for agriculture, or water resources for any sort of industries. Yeah, man-made items. So you need machineries for transportation, you need trucks, or whatever things created by human effort, means skills and their knowledge which they know to perform this activities. And definitely lastly, money. Money is also an important source for the infrastructure and running of any sort of activity. As we read through the story of Palampur, we will learn how various resources combine the procedure, the various combine to produce the desired goods and services in the village. Now, here is a description of a village, how it is. Palampur is a well connected with neighboring village and town. So the example of two is given. One is of a Rani Ganj, a big village which is just about 3 kilometers from it, and all weather road. Here the word all weather road means the roads which are available throughout the year. Yeah, in villages we have heard sometime that during monsoon season it happens due to heavy rains, flood or something, the roads are washed away and the connectivity of villages lost with the neighboring areas. But here there is an all purpose. You can say the construction of roads are really good, and they are connect. It connects the village of Rani Ganj and further to the nearest small town of Shahpur. Many kinds of transport are visible on this road, starting from bullock carts, tongas loaded with jaggery and other commodities to motor vehicles like motorcycle, jeep, tractors and trucks. This was the basic output of given, how is the village Palampur. Now, inside of the village has about 450 families belonging to several different caste. The 80 upper caste families, so it is specified that there are 80 upper caste families own the majority of land in the village. Their houses, some of them quite large, are made up of bricks with cement plastering. So here it reflects that the 80 families out of 450 families, they are well-to-do families. The standard of living is good. Their lifestyle is healthy. Yeah. Whereas on the contrary, we have some families, that is SCs, means scheduled caste, or we can say Dalit. comprising 1/3 of total population. So whatever is the total, like 450 families is the total population of a village. 1/3 of it population and live in one corner of the village in much smaller houses, some of which are the mud and straw. So you can say they are living in kaccha houses or houses which are not properly ventilated. They are not good for good living standards. Yeah. So here you can see also there is a picture of a village they have shown you. Most of the houses here have electric connections. Most of the houses here have electric connections. Electric power powers all the tube wells in the field and is used in various type of small businesses. Palampur has 2 primary schools and 1 high school. There is a primary health center run by the government and 1 private dispensary where the sick are treated. So you can see basic requirement all the which a village needs for a good standard of living, they are there. Beside the area of concern is that there is a 1/3 of population that is of scheduled caste or Dalit. They are living, the standard of their living is not up to that. The description above shows that the Palampur has a fairly well developed system of road, transport, electricity, irrigation, school and health center. You can compare this to any of the village you have seen, heard or visited till now. Now, the story of Palampur is an imaginary village will take us through the different type of production activities in the village. In village across India, farming is the main production activity. The other production activity refers to as a non-farming includes small manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping, etc. We shall take a look at both these type of activities after learning few general things of production. The next point we will moving on is like, what is a production process or what are the basic requirements for any sort of production process?